Occasionally, I look back at my older videos and cringe because they're rubbish. I try my best to keep all of these up, but sometimes I have no choice but to remove it because they are that bad. Like, seriously bad. But there was a time and place for that stuff. Back when my channels were smaller, and the comment section had more of a community feel, I could get away with jokes or stuff that I can't get away with now. Looking back at them with fresh eyes, it's easy to forget about this and to judge these videos with modern day standards. But I think this touches on a bigger, much more worrying issue. The world is changing, and what was acceptable a decade or so ago no longer is. But we're getting to that stage where the internet has been around for several decades, and changes have happened in that time. What if our past internet footprint comes back to haunt us? I think there are already instances where what people have said in the past has been used against them, now out of context and in a different world. I notice it a lot in my older videos. Going low in CSGO is a prime example. This was all recorded in 2013 and early 2014, soon after the ranks were added to the game. I deliberately lost games to try and reach the lowest rank possible. At the time, it was a jokey thing to do with friends, and since everybody wanted to improve their rank, they didn't care that I was trying to lower mine. Boy, that series has aged badly. I think because of ranked play, the community got a lot more serious, and then expected others to also behave seriously. Only after the series was recorded did smurfing become a game-wide problem. This is where players deliberately get a low rank so that they can get easy games and beat less skilled players for fun. A lot has changed in Counter-Strike, to the point where the things we did in Going Low in CSGO are seen as downright wrong and offensive to some. I have enough content on my hard drives for another 10 Going Low videos, but they'll never be released because the world has changed. It's moved on, and going low is no longer acceptable. We reached Silver 1. It took us just one night to drop through all the silver ranks. We simply killed ourselves every round. The teams we played against loved us for it. They saw it as an easy way to gain ranks, and would accept rematches from us over and over again. Rematches in Counter-Strike are almost unheard of, but some of the people we met that night would have 5 or 6 games with us in a row. This wasn't offensive content. We made a lot of people very happy that night, and I thought it was a lovely way to end the Going Low series. But artificially boosting or lowering a rank has since become incredibly frowned upon, and the game has changed as well. The ability to rematch has been removed, killing yourself has been disabled, committing suicide in other ways will also get you kicked from the game. Really, I think the Going Low series is of historical significance and only gets more interesting to watch as time goes on, but it isn't seen that way by anybody who takes the game seriously today. Also, players were a lot worse at the game back then. I was DMG in 2013, but DMG back then is like lowly silver rank today. When people watch these videos in 2019, do they understand that it's old and that things were different? Of course not. They see me playing at silver level and they think that I was bad, even back then. It's like comparing the Olympics from 100 years ago with the crazy stuff that people are capable of now. Things have changed, and it's not as simple as saying that people back then were less talented. But change can lead to more serious consequences than simply looking a bit rubbish with hindsight. Imagine if the internet had been around in the 1930s. Say the Queen Instagrammed herself doing the Nazi salute in 1933. Imagine if that salute then went on to represent terrible acts and the largest war the world has ever seen, and now there's an image of the royal family doing that salute forevermore. Oh dear. A reasonable person would understand the context, but not everybody is reasonable, are they? And do we always take the time to understand a situation, or do we sometimes like to get angry about things, using our moral superiority to justify our hatred towards the accused party? We all know a racist granny, don't we? Their odd or offensive mannerisms are remnants of a different world, back when it was more acceptable to say and to do the things that they do. We can smugly see ourselves as smarter, fairer, and superior. If we were around back then we wouldn't have been racist or anything like that. But maybe we would have. It is not okay to be racist, but it's important to understand that the situation was different back then, and that different things were deemed socially acceptable. But perhaps it's time your granny gets with the times and stops being quite so racist now, okay? We like to think that we've finally got it all sussed, that our current mindset, right now, is the perfect one, free of bias or prejudice. We will judge everything that has ever happened to the standards we currently have in our heads. But what if we don't have it right, even now? What if there are things that we'll change our minds about, 10 or 20 years down the line? I was going to say that, as a YouTuber, I have more to worry about than most, but then I think that most of us have a pretty substantial internet footprint that can and probably will be used against us at some point in the future. It wouldn't even require a dramatic change, simply lots of little ones over a long period of time. But one day we might wake up and find our past selves being used against us. Now I'm going to talk about porn. Did you know that fisting is illegal in the UK? So is humiliation, and role-playing as non-adults, or physical or verbal abuse, even if it's consensual, or spanking. They justify a face-sitting ban because it's potentially life-endangering. Some of these things are vaguely worded, but a lot of standard pornographic content that you find online will break a UK law in some form or another. Add to that how they're now going to roll out a porn block in the UK, where you have to confirm who you are to view pornographic content, and it's almost like the UK government is trying to gather dirt on everybody it can. Of course, I'm sure I'm just being paranoid and that it's for our own protection, so nothing to worry about here. Plus, I've got nothing to hide, so it won't affect me. That and VPN. The problem is, this stuff wasn't illegal until 2014. Wouldn't it be a shame if you possessed this kind of content from before 2014, forgot about it, only to have your hard drive confiscated by the police? When I talk about this, people mistake it as me being a fan of this kind of content. Obviously I'm not, because it's illegal, but I think porn laws are used because they're difficult to defend. Nobody wants to stand up for their right to bondage, because they'll be ridiculed and tarred with the same brush as the content they're trying to defend. But I think that's what they want. It undermines any resistance to these kinds of laws from being passed. I think it's important to draw a line somewhere and to regularly check back and to see if they've sneakily moved the goalposts further. At what point do you speak up about something? Or do you just think that since you accepted it yesterday, you might as well accept the changes today as well? And I think some people confuse what should be banned with what their personal preferences are. It's hard to explain what I mean without an example, so say a ban against homosexuality comes in, but since I'm straight, I don't speak up. In fact, say I go one step further and support it because I see it as some kind of popularity contest between gay and straight people. This would be utterly ridiculous in my opinion, but I see this kind of mentality from certain people. Though I think gay pride's an interesting topic. I get the argument is that it's there to empower a previously repressed group who have suffered a history of injustice, but once all that repression's been fought and it's equally acceptable to be gay, will gay pride stop being a thing? Or, if it carries on, will straight pride become an equally acceptable kind of event? This is the way I do things. To check my biases, I like to flip things and to see if it's different if the roles are reversed. In Peep Show, which I've been watching a lot of recently, again, one of the main characters wakes up to find a woman having sex with him against his will. He tells his friend and realizes he's been raped. Then it ends with him hilariously losing his job because the woman is offended he considered it rape when she was called out for it. Let's reverse the genders. A woman wakes up to find a man having sex with her against her will. She tells a friend and realizes she's been raped, and then loses her job when the man finds out she considered it rape when he was called out for it. Do you think that episode would ever have been allowed had the genders been the other way around? So, I've covered Nazis, racism, porn, and rape. I think this video might be demonetized. Although I've talked about changing perspectives as though it's a new thing, it's been around in other forms of media for centuries. It's just, for me, the internet feels different. For a start, it's not like the writers are hidden in history somewhere. It's normally a lot easier online to hunt the person down, to share what they've said, and to start a hate crusade against them using social media. Plus, if something's posted, I tend to see it as being said in the present day and not in some point of distant history. I guess it's because it's still a relatively new platform, even if the social media sites are older than some of their members. At some point, the number of dead people on Facebook is going to outnumber those still alive. And the fact that sounds sinister simply shows how new the internet era is. I hope the world takes steps to protect older content from modern day scrutiny, because as terrible and as disgusting as some of the things we've said and done in the past might be, it would be worse to lose them completely. Like fisting.